The co-captains, Stacey Jones and Kevin Campion, will lead the Warriors out tonight. As you would expect, Henry Farfilly, distinctive hairstyle, will be out there on the right wing tonight. Shontae Harvey, one of the teenagers in this squad. They're going to have a star reception. Despite plenty of Kiwi supporters being Melbourne Storm fans tonight, their allegiance will remain very much with the purple team in the home strip. Warangi Corpu, what a valuable and versatile player he can be for the Warriors.
Well, he's better known as an outside back, Corpu, but he's been sensational this year for the New Zealand Warriors. Played for the New Zealand Maoris in last year's World Cup. He's been averaging 21 tackles. He did that last week against the Roosters. A strong performer, solid runner with the football, and we can expect him to be scouting wide tonight.
Melbourne Storm. This reshuffle might have to make its way out to Colonial as well. One last walk up the tunnel, they come out to the fireworks. And of course, as has become tradition with the Storm, the huge AFL style banner. Their trust and their patience, these Storm fans tonight in this side, the banner says. Their biggest game of the season. As we said, they've squandered some chances tonight, but perhaps this man, Matt Rua, might be able to put them on the right path.
Well, perhaps this is one of the polls the players got right. Matty Rua is the best hitter in the game. Watch him make a couple of deadly tackles tonight. He's not too bad tackled his work right there. We'd like to see him run the football a bit more, but every one of those 14 tackles against the Panthers, you can still see the Panthers now, black and blue. He'll be one of their key players. Him with Richard Swain doing the defensive work, allowing the two big front rowers in Robbie Kearns and Robbie Howe to do their stuff with the ball.
Tim Mander is our referee evening, having been asked into duty yesterday at ANZ Stadium between the Broncos and the Raiders after Marco suffered a fetlock injury, if you like, in horse racing parlance. Tim Mander blows time on. And amidst the smoke haze from the fireworks under the roof here at Colonial, it will be the Melbourne Storm defending the right of screen in the first half. Lauatiti brings it up. Guttenbier, short ball onto the left-hand side where Francis Melick. A lot of time on the wing this year tonight, playing in the centres with Corpu moving into the second row. CUC will play it just outside the New Zealand Warriors 30 as Beetham tries to bump his way away from dummy half. The Melbourne Storm marker defence will be alert to his running from that position tonight. He is great value for them. The ball raked out here. Jerry CUC receives the penalty from Tim Mander. We'll give the visitors the chance to go inside Melbourne territory for the first time.
Well, they had a lot of troubles last week, the Melbourne Storm, defensively playing this compressed defensive line. They're stuck at it. Be interesting to see what type of tactics the New Zealand side come up with, whether they keep it tight or use the ball wide.
Here's Jones finding Motu Tony with Miles outside him. It comes away to Quinton Turpie. And his outside, Farfilly is there, but he stepped over the sideline.
Oh, was that an early climax?
Wasted chance on the first tackle.
Well, I think they answered your story there, Laurie. They came wide. They really want to move this football wide. They've obviously seen that it is a compressed defence. I think that'll be pretty much most of their game plan for this first 20 minutes.
Just a reassuring pat there from one of the New Zealand trainers.
Kev, stay there, mate.
He just didn't put a foot on the line. He was out by around about a foot or so. Here is Aaron Moore, who was supposed to be out of tonight's lineup. Cecil Lavia was going to take his place somewhere in the 17, but Cecil Lavia has gone back to Brisbane for the birth of a child. So Aaron Moore, who had ruled himself out, had to rule himself back in and finds himself in the starting 13. Stephen Bell swivels as he goes across the halfway line. Swain, way to Kearns. Runs at Guttenbier. Campion also there to stop him. Still a couple of tackles left for them in this first touch of the football is Orford. Gives it away to Scott Hill. Moore juggled it. Corkery was there to stop him. And that's five tackles gone. Gets in the dummy half. Orford chipping over the top, looking for the in goal. He needs the sit. It will be too big though.
Wait for me.
Shane Harpy happy to watch it.
Wait for the whistle, Monty. Monty, wait.
And they'll restart it from the 20. So you see it. Russell Fairfax told us, voted the best hitter in the game in a recent players' poll, and drove him backwards a good distance. Now it's 80. Down the short side. And now there might be a report here for a little high shot from Scott Hill. There wasn't too much in it.
Yeah, Rob, and he's there about 10 metres closer than me, mate. Okay? Yeah, just, Robbie, just let him give the report. Shane?
The tackle was around the shoulder area, but it did slip up into the head area.
Okay, right, thanks very much, mate. Rob, he's there, he's a lot closer, he's got a good look at it, it's a penalty. Okay, let's get him down.
Well, he did go high there, Scott Hill. It's been an interesting start by the Warriors. They've really been pumping down this right-hand side of the field, aiming a lot of their traffic at Matt Geyer and Scotty Hill. They're looking to shift Aaron Mill.
See what they work in this particular set of six. See you, charges forward. It comes back to Campion. It's about 34 metres out from the Melbourne Storm line. Beetha feeds it to Jones, standing flat at the advantage line. Tony, but David Miles again, a similar play to the one where Farfilly went into touch. Miles backing out the centre pond by Rodney Howe. Corpu fires it to Jones again. They go wide. Campion comes back looking for a hole between Kearns and the man on his outside. It wasn't there and he'll play it. 10 metres out from the Storm line. Jones again standing very flat when he received it. See you going back to Gordonville. It might have been grabbed before he got the ball. He's turned it over and Rodney Howe has come up with it for the Storm.
That's been one of the Storm's big problems for the last few weeks. Their defence hasn't been up to scratch. They've conceded a number of tries. Right now, though, it's holding firm.
Rook takes it just outside the 20 for the Storm. They're playing back to Swain. They get a penalty.
All in front. Here's the mark here, Scott.
Scott Hill looking to play on quickly. Will find touch into New Zealand Warrior territory. And they'll tap it. Rodney Howe on the charge as well. They weren't ready, the defensive line of the Warriors, and he went about 15 metres before getting to them. Here's Kearns now, going a long way again. And they're just outside the 20. Swain to Warford. Cut-out ball. Goes from Robbie Ross to Scott Hill. Tackled down low by Jones with the help of Corpu over the top. Swain again down the short side. Aaron Mill got away from Clinton Torpy. Dumps it backwards and Geyer does very well to keep it in play. Swain through the hands of Hill to Warford outside him. Rubbers in behind them. Kearney was the intended chaser. He didn't get a clean passage. No call from Tim Manders. So it was all fouls. So it was the Warriors blocking. Once again, tap it from the 20.
Well, it was a different start to the Melbourne Storm. What we've used to, just carting the ball forward. They're looking to attack at every opportunity. They're hitting the middle of the field, then working to the left and right edges with plenty of long balls off Orphan Hill, trying to get Aaron Mule involved as much as possible.
And I've got to tell you, they're going to put some pressure on the new fullback, David Miles. They've got a couple of kicks go through. Maybe if Ivan Curry there was there, they would not have done that.
See you. Melbourne Storm defensive line up very early again. Put some pressure on this big Warriors pack. Here's Jones, rubbering for himself this time. Chasing through that, Miles got a great bounce. Jones backing up and Geyer swoops to stop him. Just outside the Melbourne 20, it could have easily been a professional foul. Campion looking to grab it himself. Didn't get much of it. And Moala has it for the Storms. Enterprising play though from the halfback. Here's Rua. Takes it out to Ali Lauitete. Now, on the decoy for Danny Williams behind him. CUC was there with Corpu again. He's had a lot of defence early on. He's lost his jumper as well, Danny. Perhaps there's one of those kind of shoots in place tonight we weren't aware of.
On three, back up.
Swain. Goes from Danny Hunt. Across the halfway line.
Let it go, Tim Rowland.
Ross. Putting the chip in behind them. Orford will find the sideline. Just outside the Warriors 10. Fairly conservative start from the Melbourne Storm. They haven't spread it too much. Obviously, playing very close to their chest early on here with the importance of this game.
They're playing it close to their chest, working it off their own line, but when they get into the attacking zone, they're looking to spread the ball. Orphan Hill with some long balls, but the Warriors, they're numbering up their communication.
Okay, let's get the formation, make sure we're all bound together.
They're getting caught short. They're working for one another tonight. They turned the corner
inside their own 20 has been down that left-hand side. Here's Miles again with Corpu outside him. Corpu did very well to stop him. That's open. Across the 40. Bounces away from the blue tackle. Nice tackle once more for the Warriors. And it's Jones up quickly. It was Howe trying to put the pressure on by forcing to get it back. And it comes to Beetham. He flips it out the back himself. Moore couldn't get it, perhaps denied a fair chance to get it as well. Play on, says Tim Manor, and six more tackles. See you across the halfway line. A break perhaps for the Warriors. Let's see if they can cash in. Campion to Jones, lovely ball around the TT.
He knocks it back, and then Kupu dives on it, and from there, great work. Campion looking as though he was just taking the ball up, found support. And then from there, Melly on to Harpy. He had a lot to do. We beat Mawala, and then straight through the tackle of Robbie Ross. And that was a great start for the Warriors.
Yeah, cruel twist of fate, but you can't help that. The Warriors certainly took advantage. Some class play. Big step off that left foot, Jim. Apparently two flimsy tackles when you consider so much at stake with the first try of the match. But he just strolls around, gives him a better shot, and this should be 6-0.
We can expect more of the same tonight off the New Zealand Warriors. Getting the forwards and looking like he's going to hit the ball up, but then got support play on the outside and licking it. You notice with the Melbourne Storm compressed defensive goal is Jones. As he attempted shot at goal, he puts it over. They don't move up on the outside men. They're playing compressed. When they slide, they're sliding backwards. Any change of direction, it's pretty hard to defend against. And if they run the right angles here tonight, then the Warriors could make the Storm pay.
They will play from in front. Sam Boyd, 6 points to nil. We've had just over 10.5 minutes. Tim Mander and Matt Orford, more in particular. Might a little more sand out there on the halfway line. And we'll have time off. For the moment, of course, you can no longer use the plastic tee to kick off from the halfway line.
Our
officials were concerned that kickers were getting too much of an advantage as far as getting the ball in the air and hang time and letting the defence to get through and put some pressure on the receiving team. So the sand has been delivered. And it's Orford who will place it to get us back underway. And they've done the first job, the Warriors.
No starts.
Continue on. They've still got almost 70 minutes though to wait. See you, bringing it back from the kickoff. Just inside his own 20. Jones, they go wide for Lala Titi. Standing out there with Melly outside. Another lovely ball back on the inside of Goodenville. What skills Lala Titi possesses. Campion. Back to Melly. Steps past a couple of them, still going. A ball out the back as well. It's razzle dazzle. It's showtime here already at Colonial Stadium. They're the LA Lakers of the NRL. Miles to Clinton Tolkien. He's wrapped up by Moore as they spread to the right hand side. Marfili. Long pass to Jones. Decoy pass to Suyusu, and then it comes back through Campion away to Tony. As Lower to the end here again. Shontan Harpy fires it back inside, but going above the pack. And the home of AFL with Scott Hill.
We've got to be careful not to get too excited, the Warriors. This New Zealand, this Melbourne storm side, they will keep running away. New Zealand, they're having a lot of success going wide, but after points, the best thing to probably do is get your kick and then try and build your game again.
Here's Rodney Howe. How quickly to meet him was Kevin Campion. Stopped him in his tracks. Swain now. Give it back to Danny Williams. Not as much go forward from the Melbourne Storm forwards. Now Kearney. A real miscommunication in those last couple of tackles. Nobody seemed to know who was going to take the hit up. It's cost them dearly here. Here's Farfilly. 40 out from their Melbourne Storm line. Chance to add to this score. Jones. Away to Melly. There's been more than a handful for Stephen Bell and Matt Rua out there so far. Harpy gives it to Jones. Now with Titi. Dumps it again. Suyusu does likewise to Monty Beetham. He pushed away from Rodney Howe's tackle. Rodney Kearns had to help Richard Swain out.
You're out, Bobby.
Jones. David Miles again. Bonus playing as the 5-8 here so far. Here's Torpy going from dummy half. Farfilly outside him. Touched perhaps by Matt Dyer. In fact, it was. Confirmation from Tim Mander. Six more tackles for the Warriors. And they're just 10 metres away. Looking for try number two on the runaround. Jones gets it back from Suyusu.
After the third tackle in a row, the Warriors had a player standing around the dummy half, making it really difficult for the markers. Three times in a row now.
Beetham got within two of the line. Farfilly, good ball to Jones. They've got them stretched, or Tony lost his footing. It bounced up for Campion, though. Goodenbill wrapped up by Danny Williams. Campion, dummies one way. Goes to Lamartini. Trouble here for the Storm. He pops it back to Campion, to Goodenbill, to Jones. He bypasses Suyusu. No to Tony, who certainly can step. But this time, Richard Swain once again run it well. Beetham again from dummy half for the second time in this set of six. They've used up five of them. Suyusu gives it back to Jones. The bomb this time. Farfilly is up out wide. It's up over the top of Matt Dyer. Came down with it as well to score try number two.
Well, just took the ground. Just took the ground, mate.
Well, he's happy with the onside. He just wants the grounding to be looked at. We've seen this a number of times this season. Stacey Jones putting the ball up for Fafili, the best leaper in the Warriors side. He climbed on the back of Matt Geyer, AFL style. We'll have a look at the put down. He's definitely onside. You can see how much width they've got in their attack this season, the New Zealand side. He goes up, he comes down with it. That angle you cannot tell.
You'll be able to, though, from this one. Still got it. There it is. No doubt. Henry Farfilly picks up try number two for the New Zealand Warriors, and they're doing it nicely at the moment. It's about to be 10 points to nil.
Well, they're doing it nicely, and it's coming on the back of some second-phase play. The ability of this big New Zealand side to keep the ball alive. The Storm just can't go with them at the moment.
There's the try side video referee tonight, Mick Stone. The wingers have got both of them. Harpy at the first occasion, Farfilly in the second, and here it is again.
Well, I think you're dead right, Molly. I talk about width of attack. Okay, so it's a kick, but that's what they're doing. They're playing the extremities. They're trying to stretch that defence. No one really out there. We're just one-on-one. He was just, and you said it, Laurie, he is the best looper in this Warriors outfit, and he was head and shoulders above his opposite number.
Stacey Jones, who supplied the bomb from about 5 metres in from this touchline. We're trying to convert and make it 12 points to nil. If you give them too much of a lead, this Warriors side, they're going to be very tough to run down. But Melbourne Storm, throughout the year, have shown that they can score tries in bunches. As Henry Farfilly picks up his 14th of the season, but playing for your NRL life, they can't afford to give them much of a start.
No, well, we talk about second phase play. The Warriors are probably the best at it in this competition. They've come up in what's probably been regarded as the Melbourne Storm's biggest strength, is their ability to stop the offloads. But at the moment, it looks like high school team playing against the primary school team. The Storm, they just cannot put the ball carrier on the ground.
I'm worried he's going off me, though.
Also, Laurie, a couple of those two tries, they both come off possessions that the Storm have nearly gathered. You know, they touch the ball, six again, and away they go. That's come from, two tries have come from that, so it's just a bit of bad luck for the Storm at this stage.
Jones hits it low and left. Short of a pace as well. Got a nice buffer early on here after 16 minutes. They lead the Storm 10 points to nil.
It'll be interesting to see the mindset of the New Zealand players. This set of six, last set of six, they went from one sideline to the other. Didn't get to their kick, they turned the ball over.
Orford. They'll come down to Campion. And Richie Villasanti, who's out there for his first touch. Straight through them from the kick return. He needs one more pass. Farfilli was with him, but he couldn't get it to him. Farfilli to Jones. They've got them stretched to the right-hand side. That's where they're going now as far as the Melbourne's defensive line is concerned. Here is Motu Tony coming back midfield, wrapped up by Peter Robinson.
No, Peter!
Campion. Another offload for the lock forward. Peetham standing also. Comes to Swan, who finally gets him to grass. Seven missed tackles so far for the Storm. Tells a story as far as the scoreline goes. Here's Miles showing it, running it off. Might have caught the knock around the chest of the straight region, in fact, in that tackle. Jones, cut out ball. He finds Motu Tony. Another touch there by Scott Hill. Picked up and knocked on, in fact, by Henry Perenara. That will be six more tackles for the Blackbirds. The Storm can't take a trick. Harvey plays it. Jones, Beefer, away to Miles, and Torby outside him, steps back inside, now, lovely ball to Corby, who was ankle-tapped 2 metres away.
Hard penalty over here, you've taken the man out. Storm. You've taken him out.
Double knock on
it. No, it wasn't. The first one was not played, that second one was.
Quick tap taken by Beefer. Here's Jones, Campion. He's 10 away, midfield. Oh. For their third try of the game.
Danny Williams.
Alarm bells ringing for the Melbourne Storm already. Here's Jones. Away to Motu Tony. Three of them in the tackle, including Fafita Moala, who'd come in a long way off his wing. Now a TD from dummy half. He'll take some stopping. Gutenberg for Stacey Jones. Turns it back for Villasanti. Made the long bass from the kickoff to put them in this position.
Get back, get back, Richard.
Here's Beetham. Ball back on the inside for Whitfield. They're waiting for him. Burns his leg to it. As well as Scott Herring. Five gone. Is there another bomb coming from Stacey Jones? No, there's not. They'll run it. Here's Miles. Corpu outside him. Into a lovely gap. Ball back on the inside for Miles. He's in.
Storm. It all came about by the penalty. Another set of six. They're just taking the gas out of this Storm side. The Storm are defending and defending. But you watch Jones on this play. Last tackle. Looking like he's just going to run the ball through on his legs. And he passes the ball to Miles. Again, just hitting the hard. Then an offload back to Miles. The Storm defenders, they're tired from doing too much defence.
Oh, it was.
Stephen Kearney was in the line here. That was the drama. It allowed this play to come on a shorter angle. Stephen Kearney eventually gets to him, but it's way too late. Miles just too strong near the line. The defensive line of the Melbourne Storm was at sixes and sevens. They've got to tighten it up, make it straight, especially on their line, or this is going to happen to them all night.
One of the reasons you have a compressed defensive line is that you want to stop to go forward. And the Melbourne Storm aren't doing that. They're making holes in New Zealand side when they're running the football. It's dragging the numbers in. They're not slowing down the ruck area. And when they're going wide, they haven't feel that.
Here's Jones from wide out. This one is across the black dot. And it's a handsome lead they possess now. 16 points to nil. They're going at almost a point a minute here. Melbourne Storm. If this continues, won't miss out on the finals. They'll be blown out of the water.
Again, Warren, another... Robbie Kearns thought it was a double knock on, but they had the chance to regather the football. Six tackles later on the penalty. Try number three.
Awful. With the restart again, it comes down for Campion, who this time bypasses Richie Villasanti. Just stumps it forward himself.
Just look at those tackles, Warren. More than double.
Stop. And two. Stand up.
This tackle tell a story also. Nine for the Storm, one for the Warriors. Here's a penalty to the Storm, to the Warriors rather. Team man that wants a word with Robbie Kearns.
Mate, you might be frustrated, but it's coming out in these sort of silly little penalties. Okay, he's trying to get up, you just pushed him over, it's unnecessary. It's a whole range of things, Robbie.
I just feel like we're not getting that fair going.
Well, mate, it's not nothing to do with me, OK? I'm calling the house, I see him, and that's what's happening. So let's just get a bit of discipline, OK?
Well, luck certainly has been against the Melbourne Storm. Three times, as you said, Russell. They've given up six again, and on the back of each of them, the Warriors have scored a try and hence their 16-point lead. Here's Lauatiti. He's standing very wide out there on the left-hand side. And for once, they stop him before he can get an offload away. The offloads also tell a story. Seven for the Warriors, one for the Storm. It's on the lead by Danny Williams. They force him over the sideline.
Get the football, or my team needs to get the football. It's almost 70-30 with the possession.
That's not my fault.
I'm going to tell you, the Storm are just about out on their feet. They need to get the football. They need to make the opposition work.
Okay. I think honestly, the Storm have to revert back to maybe the up and in style defence that they've been so famous for over the years.
He didn't knock it on, but Aaron Mill certainly did. Sure.
When you play the New Zealand Warriors, you've got to be aggressive. In a slight defence, if you're not stopping them in the go-forward department, they will just run things around you.
Kevin,
I think they've got to get some aggressiveness back in their game, therefore getting off the line, putting pressure on
them. No, you're not square. No. Yeah.
They receive a penalty here, the Melbourne Storm. They might have had some bad luck in this game, but when they've had the ball, they have just been awful with it. They were lucky on the first tackle not to knock it on. They may well have, in fact, but got the call from Tim Mander to play on.
Right, mark the square.
And Matt Geyer threw a crazy ball back over his shoulder into the field of play when he perhaps thought he was going to be bunted into touch. Here's Robbie Ross. Danny Williams going up for the intercept. Scott Hill into a bit of space. He's got it.
Second phase play, doing the Warriors on the Warriors, and then Scott Hill, nice little dummy there. Beetham went for the inside man. Hill and offload to Steve Bell, goes over in the corner.
Well, I spoke about them needing the football. That was the start of it. And now that pass there put Scotty Hill into space. It was an attempted intercept by Melly, and he just didn't quite get there. Scott Hill then just played the normal running game. They had him for numbers out wide, put Bell into some space, and he wasn't going to fluff that one. So important, they are now back.
Matt Orford from right out there on the far touchline. Four from six last week against the Panthers. Looking at almost 70% in this season 2001 in the NRL. Hits it pretty well. Hooking away, go across the face of the post, but they're on the border, at least. the first hurdle. 16 points to 4. They trail by 2 converted tries. And as we said just a short while ago, throughout this season, when they've trailed a team by a fair margin, they have shown they can score tries in a bunch.
They like to throw the football around the Melbourne Storm. That was a good bit of, well, they got a good bit of luck out of that set there. They've got to do more with it. They're good with the ball, but defensively, that's where they've got to get their house in order.
Robinson it is who brings it back from the kickoff. Robbie Kearns, driven backwards by Villa Santi, also Monty Beetham.
Well, this set of six so important to them on. They cannot afford to make a mistake. They've got to play out their five tackles, get a nice long kick in.
Kearns to Swain. As Williams outside him. Back up towards the halfway line. They picked up some good meters already. Orford goes to Scott Hill. Thought about the kick, but just made it across the line. They push him into touch as well. They're killing themselves.
Here they go, turning over possession at halfway.
They thought about the kick. Little dummied as though he was going to put the kick in. And then just crammed across the field.
Okay,
really,
let's everybody buy in.
The defensive line this Warriors team possesses.
There we go.
The time you do that, you really give them a chance to put you over the line. They didn't waste that chance on that occasion. It's Francis Milley. Just outside his own 40-metre line. It's Harvey again. Comes across the halfway line himself. Strong, strapping winger he is. Here's Corpu.
Stand Steve!
Even gets to dummy half.
We're off.
Jones, the first receiver, as you'd expect, with Woodbill back inside him. Andrew Tony slipped once again. Times to Mike Jones, had to get there another bit of cleanup. Miles gives it on to Tukey. Unmistakable figure, hits it up. He's just outside the Storm 40 metre line as Jones puts the kick in. Andy Ross is playing fairly deep and will carry it off the left hand. Brings it back to Guttenbill, who stops him just outside the Melbourne Storm 10. See if they can complete a set of six on this occasion. Oh, Moana has put it down in the tackle, through the legs of Orford. Back to Matt Geyer.
On two. Hold it, hold it steady.
Matt Geyer isn't happy about something in the tackle there. Back, still playing on the ground, is Fafita Moala. Puts the ball in the tackle there, he's hurt. Here's Kearney, down the blind side, as Jones goes low, hangs on to him for the ride. Swain, for Robbie Kearns. Across the halfway line, he passed away from the Campion tackle, and then it was knocked on by the Warriors.
Ball went back from Robbie Kearns, then either accidental offside or knock on there. Sorry, Peter. No, that's your feed, yeah.
Either way, the Storm will get the ball back again in Warriors territory.
You guys have touched into each other.
Last couple of sets of six. The Storm will look good carting the ball forward. They're running with a lot more aggression. Stephen Carney, Robbie Kearns. Let's play a stop. Fafita Moala was hit in a bone-crunching tackle by Maringi Kupu. Stopped him dead in his tracks.
Well, they've just been, I mean, nothing to lose, but they've just been bashing them up front. It's been as solid as anything there. The point of the shoulder coming right under the face of, he was almost out before he hit the ground. That's why the ball went loose.
It was Tubi, in fact, not Kupu. They tend to get them mixed up.
Rorty and Bowden still waiting on the Melbourne Storm bench. You can see he just runs into the shoulder, Clinton Torpy. Was a bit of trouble. Straight away, pretty much the ball coming close to his grasp, and they were lucky to clean up.
Well, and that was nothing illegal, no swinging arm there, but point of contact, first point of contact was with the head, no doubt about that.
Yeah, I wouldn't hold your breath waiting for them to happen, though, as far as that one goes. It's just one of those things that happens out there.
Well, I bet the Storm would like it. That will allow them to have a fresh replacement now, and they'll be one shy.
And they've also got four forwards on the bench. Before Moana is a winger. So it'll be interesting to see the makeup of the defensive line for the Melbourne Storm.
Mark Murray, of course, will now have to work out some challenges as far as his back line goes, because he was at one stage going to have Levia on the bench, or at least in the side for Aaron Moore, as Moana gets loaded into the stretcher. Daniel Anderson holding the coach's box for Tony Kemp alongside him. But for the Melbourne Storm, they have Henry Perenara, Peter Robinson, Russell Bowden and Ben Rorty on their bench, four forward, so it means there will have to be a reshuffle somewhere across the line.
Well, what will happen? Will Stephen Kearney go to halfback and push maybe Orford out defensively and then with the tack bring him back in?
I think we'll find Henry Perenara, who can fill a number of spots, will just go out into the centres, and perhaps either Stephen Bell, who plays on that right-hand side, will go to the wing.
We're going to find it difficult whichever way they go. Perenara, better known as a back row, and all the traffic has been going to the edge. So Perenara defends a lot in tight. He won't be used to defending out wide. It's a difficult position to defend in the centres.
You're right about that, Ben Amon. All their attack to the fringes, and guess who's on the fringe? Anthony Orford all the time.
Freddie Moana will take every precaution with him. Russell Bowden also ready to come on. He will be the replacement for Moana, as Perenara had already been substituted for one of the other players, and of course, as a scrum has been called,
Bowden
can't come onto the field until after the ball goes back into play.
Well, I don't agree with that rule when someone gets taken off. I think if they're going to make a replacement in an interchange, that's correct. But if someone gets injured, you should be able to replace him straight away.
There's Aaron Miller, of course, who was a little bit of irony in Miller because he was against the Roosters a few weeks back with the score. When somebody was coming from the field, and the Roosters scored a try, which set them on a point-scoring frenzy at the football stand. Bowden driven backwards, just outside the 20. Hill at first receiver. Orford outside him, he cuts back to the inside. Coming across field also, lovely front ball for Robinson. And equally a good tackle from Donisella.
No,
they caught. Giving up a penalty.
Here's the mark.
Quick tap, Orford onto Robbie Kearns. He might even get there. They twist him just in time. We'll play it back to Richard Swain. Great chance for the Storm. Bowden bouncing off defenders. Melly was there to stop his progress. He'll play it quickly. Swain, this time away to Rodney Howe. They're up quickly to stop him. Tiki is there. 10 out from the Warriors' line, throwing by 12. Here's Orford, showing him one way, going the yellow, Robbie Ross. He bounced off it back, he had a look up at Quinton Talk.
No, you're offside.
No.
Just take it easy. You were never back, mate. You're never back onside, okay? No way. To see whether he's grounded that or not. No, I was waiting to see what sort of advantage you guys would get if it's no try, okay?
Good call here by Tim Mander. I'll tell you what though, Robbie Ross will have an anxious wait here. The first replay pretty much will reveal all, you would think, but he didn't look too confident. Was the one-handed put down. I think he may have just missed time, but he's dropped it.
Well, we always talk about putting the ball down with two hands. Robbie Ross taking the football, holding it in one hand, and he has absolutely murdered that one.
still can't believe the referee was saying, I can't wait. I'll wait and see what type of advantage you've got.
No, I think he's done the right thing, Tim Bender. It should be play on, obviously. Ross has knocked on, and then the Warriors, had they gone the length of the field, they've got time to score a try themselves, so he just plays out the tackle. They'll get the ball back here. It's not much of a difference for them. There's no try. Tim Bender restart on the line. So I'll tap it. They will save the tackle. And here's Turkey, picked up by Richard Smith, and dumped, but he's back.
That might just be the spur that the Storm need to get their act together. What has happened to the rule? As soon as you get out of the line, get to the ground and score the try.
Wouldn't be a high tackle out here.
That's okay.
Robbie Kearns is the man. It's just a slapping motion. Yeah.
Just lazy, Robbie. Just lazy, mate. Yep.
100% again.
I suppose the left arm out here. Just caught him around the neck. Probably nothing in it. Penalty will be sufficient. Once again, the Warriors will come on the attack. But I tell you what, Daniel Anderson, everybody concerned with the Warriors will be a little bit concerned at the meters and the gaps that have opened up in this New Zealand Warriors defensive line in the last 10 minutes or so.
Well, realistically, they should be back to 16-10, but it is remaining at 16-4.
Hold us, Ashley.
Here's Tuki. Good tackle from Robbie Jones, trying to get from the side.
It's a scrum, we didn't have the fifth play the ball.
Great hit, strong, great hit.
No, it's got to be after the play the ball, fifth to play the ball. Technicality.
There it is, he dropped it. Came before the ball again.
That's scrum, yep, there we go.
As opposed to being a straight turnover.
It's got
to
be after the play the ball.
The Melbourne Storm getting it from the scrum field.
Okay, nice and easy, nice and easy.
Just over 7 minutes left in the first half.
No, don't get sucked in.
So here at Colonial.
No push, fellas. Money. No push. Here we go. Put it there. Rodney Hale.
He'll find the line to the Storm. Will pick up them again. It's going to be a 6-point ball game, this.
Well, that's been the story of the Storm's night. They wanted a quick tap there, but Matty Guy just lazy passing the ball and hitting the ground. Just stops the momentum that the Storm are trying to build.
Chances with it. Runs it across the dead ball line. Storm will get 6 more tackles.
Well, that's just what the Storm would want right now. Another shot at him, because I can tell you, there is some holes, Warren. You mentioned there's some holes opening up in the Warriors' defence. They are now starting to get tired as we start to win up the possession a little bit more. But now they've actually got their game plan together now, the Melbourne Storm. They're holding the ball for sets of six and they're working away. Trouble time now for the Warriors. They can't keep them out. Wow.
Tony again. They slipped over. He's on ice skates out there at times tonight.
They penalised people for being in front of the kickoff. I can't believe that Tim Mander hasn't penalised Matu Tony there for being in front.
from the dropout.
This one.
Come on, Monty.
The way to Warford. Bound and also hitting the deck.
Jerry.
And he's just 8 metres away. Options either side. They go to the right. Taken by Peter Robinson. He has enough of scoring big tries in important games. They roll him.
Hold up. Nah, it's fine.
Yep. So again, they'll get 6 more for the scrum. 10 metres out.
Well, they won't be unhappy with that. The Melbourne Storm. They're just building pressure, and it's a good field position to be attacking from. A scrum 20 metres in gives the opportunity for an Aaron Mule to go one-on-one with Stacey Jones. You watch Jones, he defends out on the right-hand side. He won't defend at the scrum.
Let's get the formation. He
didn't get the ball wide.
Don't break early, mate.
You have an opportunity to go one-on-one with Jones. See the tackle, 179.
Sorry, Larry Orford going from the scrum is picked up by Corpoo and he's knocked it on his goal
net. One on one.
Did this hit the ground? That's the question.
I couldn't hear you over the players, mate.
It was almost away.
Back up here, fellas. Back up here. Richard, just back up, mate.
Two men have got a word from his touch judge, Stephen Richards. We know about the slight knock on from that Orford.
Pack properly.
Jones this time. The Warriors now with a bit of their hands. Feeding the scrum. Corporal took it. Now CUC. Player went down. CUC came to him. Robinson knocks it backwards. Play on still at this point in time. Comes back to Stephen Bell. He changes his mind. Oh, throws it. Pass to Matt Guy who put him under all sorts of pressure. He lost in the tackle. Here's Jason Deith with it. Happening out there. Here's Beaufort to Jones. They've got them stretched again. Lovely hands from Melly. Stepping back inside them. Gets it back down to Tony. And here's Harvey who will get his second for the Warriors. What about the 60 seconds of play that led up to the try? They lead 20 points to 4. Orford knocked it on. I don't know who it was for the Storm as CUC. Slipped straight over and opened up a huge hole, and that was the catalyst for the try.
It came from a turnover from Matt Orford. Then you thought that the Storm had won the ball back, got hold of possession. Stephen Bell tries to find Matt Geyer, puts him under all sorts of pressure. And then Coopy, that I can't believe that was played on. I thought he was held there. The tackle was completed. But from there, Stacey Jones sees the numbers, they're short. On to Melly, strong runner of the football. It's their ability to play second phase play. Gives a great ball there, Motu Tony, to Chartain Happy. And Happy goes up, and that is his second try for the Melbourne.
There it is, I agree with you as far as the Matt Geyer incident. No doubt I thought that he was tackled and lost the ball after being tackled, which would have been a scrum.
And if we're talking about video referee decisions, why couldn't they have gone back? Why couldn't they have asked the referee when he went over to score the try line? That's the grey area about the game and getting the video referee in. The Melbourne Storm have got every right to complain. There's been some decisions that have gone against them tonight.
One word, Laurie, consistency, we're not getting it.
Here's Jones, it's dead straight and straight inside the left-hand uprights. A huge piece of fortune for them. 22 points to 4. A lead by 18 in the last minute before the break.
Can you believe that? Another try from yet another turnover for the Storm.
Every one of them so far. Matt Orford with the kickoff. No doubt from the kickoff, but Peter Robinson was a step and a half in front of the kicker as well. Speaking of inconsistencies, it should be a fairly easy one, you'd think, that one from the kickoff.
It's a position that referees get themselves into.
At least, run away!
And here's Beaufort playing it. Spin it. Just 20 seconds before the break. Here's Lauatiti, another lovely ball back on the inside. What skills he has, Guttenbill still going. It's about 6 metres short of the halfway line. This will be the last tackle. What have they got? Perhaps a chip over the top from Jones. So he'll chip over the top for Henry Farfilly. He gets a good bounce here. It could be another bounce if he goes across the touchline. thing too for the Melbourne Storm, because that might have been just about it when the Warriors scored on the siren at half time. An exciting half of football from them. They did get their fair share of luck. They took their chances when they were presented to them. And they lead 22 points to 4 at the break. Shontayne Harvey crossed for 2 of their 4 tries. We'll take a break and come back to look at all those highlights from the first half in just a moment. Still half time here at Colonial Stadium as we take a look at the work rate with Russell Fairfax.
Yeah, no secret that the Storm have done most of the defensive work in this first 40 minutes. Richard Swain, well, we know he's the best defensive player in the game, just makes tackle after tackle. Williams is way up there. Robbie Kearns. Now, what Kearns has got to do, along with how they've got to start to alter that second column, the hit-ups. They've got to mount the hit-ups and go across the Warriors. It's been a pretty comprehensive champion there, lock forward and skipper. You know, he just leads by example all the time. Cooper's been outstanding out wide. There's no doubt about that. Been exceptional. Monty Beetham, the hooker, is also 9-6, 9 tackles and 6 hit-ups, so he's having a fairly solid game as well. I've got to say, Warren, looking at those stats, this second 40 minutes, we're in for a very exciting finish.
Well, the Melbourne Storm can score some tries and put them together in a hurry at times this year. Of course, a game against the Dragons, where they did exactly that. They almost lost it when they allowed the Dragons back into the game. In fact, their biggest comeback since halftime, since coming into the league, in fact, is when they were down 14 points to nil against the Dragons. That was the 1999 grand final, where they went on to win courtesy of the penalty try to Craig Smith, 20 points to 18.
And of course, this is a different side now to the one they had in 99. It was a great first half of football, especially by the New Zealand team, keeping the ball alive. Their second phase play has been outstanding. We might be in for a bit of history here in the next 40 minutes if the Warriors can continue their good form, making the semi-finals for the first time. The Melbourne Storm, on the other hand, they have 40 minutes to keep themselves alive. They have been struggling in defence in the first 40 minutes. That's an area that I'm sure Mark Murray will be impressing upon his players to improve. But the Warriors have just got to keep playing as they see.
Instilled in his players, well, listen, we've got to have a bit of ball security in this second half. They've cost themselves 4 tries in that first half. Secondly, they've got to deny the Warriors some possession. They do that. There is some holes. They're not the best defensive outfit in the NRL, the Warriors. And given enough possession, the Storm can mount a comeback, vice versa. No secret what the Warriors are going to do. Keep the ball, play the game down the Storm end. Storm's end, simple as that.
Back to an earlier game here, also in Colonial, when the Storm were down by 30 points against the Newcastle Knights at half time, and they came back to almost inch that one against the Knights. So, while there's life, there's hope. There's still 40 minutes left. They only trail by 18, which, as the Warriors prove themselves against the Bulldogs, you can rack up in something like, well, 8 or 9 minutes. As Tim Mander is one of the blow time back on. We have it. It is 0-2 Tony. He gets the kickoff away. It will be the Melbourne Storm who bring it back out from their 20. Robbie Kearns to Richard Swain from dummy half. And Robbie Hand, the arm firm. Here's Robinson. Back up within about 6 metres of the halfway line for just 3 tackles. Here's Orford. Kearney cutting back on the inside. Hasn't really been a factor tonight. And Orford. Good kick early in the count. He's playing fairly shallow. Tracks back to field 5 metres out from his own line. We'll see if the Warriors in this 40 minutes possess that grip that they showed last week against the Roosters. Well, Danny, you wrapped them very heavily during the week in the Big League magazine, and then again for the game. And,
well, clean out, clean out.
They are to be a factor in the finals. They need to show that they can muscle up here and shut the Storm out of this game.
Well, it is a good test for the Warriors, leading at 18 points into the second half. Last week against the Roosters, I thought they turned the corner mentally. It's always been a problem with the New Zealand sides collapsing. This might be a different New Zealand side. Robbie Ross is straight through.
Comes to David Miles, who stops him just short of the halfway line. Here's Stephen Bell going from dummy half. He gets it back to Russell Bowden. Peter Robinson keeps it alive. It comes to Henry Perinara, and he stopped 5 metres into New Zealand Warrior territory. They're a man short of the defensive line at the moment because Motu Tony is lying back downfield concussed. Here's Robinson as the Storm keep it alive. Robbie Ross again, who started the whole movement off. You think they would want to spread left after some plays down the right-hand side, but they were flat with not much doing there, but here they come now. Scott Hill to Stephen Kearney. He's standing, tackled there. 25 out. Here's Orford to Robinson. Hill juggling it. Off Stacey Jones, not played and knocked on by Richard Swain. Torpy fires it to Campy. He gives it off to Monty Beetham. Real chance wasted by the Melbourne Storm, though. And too slowly going to the left-hand side. And in fact, we'll have time off here because the New Zealand Warriors have another player down there.
Well, this could be a real big test for the New Zealand side. Ali Latiti went off hurt just before half-time. He's not back out there on the bench at the moment. Motu Tani's been taken off with an ankle injury. And there is a guy down in the back plate. They might be down to one guy on the bench, the New Zealand Warriors. And this would be a big blow. And they are calling for the stretcher. So it does not look good.
Yeah, in fact, I think you'll find, I was going to say it's Monty Beetham, but it's not. It might be Shontaine Harpy.
Kev, no, mate.
In fact, it is Shontaine Harpy. You can see now that it is. Once again, he's just behind Robbie Kearns there and got the hip of Kearns when he was being dragged along behind him. First angle, you look at it, and he gets crunched as well. Double jeopardy for Shontaine Harpy. He's not at all well as you'd expect after two contacts like that. And they are in trouble, as you said, Laurie, now as far as fresh reserves on the bench.
We see Motu Tony standing up there. He looks like he'll be the replacement. He looks a bit ginger on the leg. But in times of trouble, you really have to guts it out. And they are playing for a top eight position tonight, the New Zealand side. It'd be terrific for football in the country of New Zealand if they were able to make it. This is not going to hurt. As we've seen Latiti coming back out as well.
And still Shontaine Harpy looking after him. They're going to take every precaution as well. Concerned, obviously, Daniel Anderson, his coaching staff looking on high up here at Colonial Stadium. Just minutes into the second half, couldn't be worse for them. Motu Tony went off, as we saw, that ankle injury. And now, Shontaine Harpy down, and you would think very unlikely, obviously, to play any part further in this game. Beetham. Who knows the situation? Jordan Frame out there. Motu Tony coming back to the sideline, so he'll be forced back into action immediately.
You don't like to see any injury, especially not to a young man who's just 19 years of age, Shontaine Harpy. Let's just hope it's precautionary and he'll continue to play in the NRL for the remainder of the 2001 season and beyond. You are right, Ron, they are taking plenty of precautions here.
Everybody, it's all hands on deck. Looking after Shontaine Harpy now. You can see Ali Lauatiti, as you mentioned, Laurie, back out there now. He wasn't there at the the start of the second half and looks fairly ginger as he was walking back to the bench. Mark Turkey and also Richard Villasanti got to warm up to perhaps come back onto the field. Things happening in a hurry here for the Warriors, and a little bit bad for them so far. Turkey claps his injured teammate onto the medicab, and that's a sorry sight. Replacements for the New Zealand Warriors. Players going off injured, of course. Which are a result of foul play, all count. And the replacements, and the New Zealand Warriors, with Harvey leaving the field in the medicab, have just used their eight. So they have just four replacements left for the entire second half. We'll wait and see if Harley Lauatiti is in any sort of condition to be one. Was a long way downfield before he stopped by Perenara, who gives away a penalty.
Straight over the top.
This will be interesting. They lead by 18. They're just inside the 30. The kick for goal, they would have thought, had to go for goal to make it an even 20 and make the Melbourne Storm score four times in the game, but they won't. They'll play on. See you to Jones. Here's Motu Tsai. Set of six for the Melbourne Storm. Jones gives it off to Campion, taken around the head by Howell. He'll be called out.
No.
Similar tackle to the Robbie Kearns.
Just hold it steady.
Just a slight slapping motion, but contact to the head. Tim Mann, they had to blow a penalty. Time, surely, from the ensuing penalty, they had to take the kick for goal.
Certainly
got him high. It'll be interesting to see what type of action the referee will take.
It was lazy, hitting high, and hitting right across here. We're going to have to whack it on report, okay?
It's on report.
It's not going to go anywhere. The same deal as in the first half. Let's get a bit of discipline. I can't keep blowing penalties, mate. I will do something extra, okay?
Yeah, okay. I'm trying.
Well, just slow it down. Just slow it down a bit, Stace, and take a step.
Kevin Campion. Getting a word from the trainer, perhaps isn't all that impressed with the instructions he got from the sideline. Curious reaction that, because from this position, it was always surely going to be a moral that they had to take the kick for goal. In fact, now we know why Kevin Campion wasn't that happy, because he's going to be replaced by Richard Villasanti. And well, given they've only had four changes left, and well, Campion has only played 5 minutes or less than 5 minutes here in the second half, and there was a long time out while we had Shontayne Harvey down the stretcher. That is a very curious decision. He had to be fresh. Will be, of course, I just mentioned interchanges. There will be a free interchange because it was as a result of foul play, so it won't use up an interchange. In fact, thank God those grey cells kicked in the nick of time, Laurie, before I completely goosed myself.
I wasn't going to help you out.
No starts.
Thanks for the help. Solid in the trenches as always. Notice the former long-haired Roosters fullback was pretty quietly in there as well.
You were doing it all yourself, Laurie.
Hole! Or some sort of hole. See you. Remember that, boys. Deep, get away the good bit. See you. Back to deep. Here's David Miles straightening. Burns got him. About 15 short of the halfway line. Robbie Ross. score with 8 changes left in the game. The Warriors now with 4 still. The graphic said 3, but that will be 4 changes left further. Unless there was another one who slid on out there when we weren't watching. Here's Richie Swain going from Danny Hart. Scott Hill just outside the 30. A trail by 20. We come in at them. Here's Orford. Giving it back to Peter.
Football, but Peter Robinson in the second half, he's made some sensational charges to start off with, really hitting the edge of the ruck. They just need their support play to pick up the Storm. They're getting their arms free, they just haven't got anyone following, trailing the runner as he's lost the ball.
He came free in the tackle. Those things were happening at the end of the field in the first half, the Melbourne Storm. Now it's the Warriors who are coughing it up.
Yeah, the man. The tackle there, number 17, Scotty Hill, raised him up a little bit, a little bit of fear, out popped the football.
Okay, nice, let's get the formation, bend the backs, stay in there, Locke, stay in there, Monty.
Now Orford, at the Warriors 20, has it from the scrum base, for Scott Hill, angling outside him, Quentin Torpy was watching outside him, David Miles kept coming with Hill and made the tackle. Ross showing it to Richie Swain. And then Russell down it. Nobody really drawn out of the defensive line for the Warriors. Here's Robbie Kearns. Campion now. Back out there. Oh, Robbie Harris put it down.
Both ways.
Finally half an hour left and trailing by 20. They can't afford that.
Hey, get out. Come on, get out. Roll out, roll out.
Howe might have reacted to something that was said to me by one of the Warriors, and then he saw Manny Beetham in his face and thought the better of it.
Yeah, yeah. No, we're going to wait for you. Take it easy. No, Warriors, walk back. No, don't stuff around here now. Take it easy. No, Kevin, just go down.
The concern looks at the Melbourne Storm brain stressed. John Rebo, Chris Johns rather, with John Rebo returning up there. Campion, dummy half, hitting it. Oh, good again. Rodney Howe came out of the line like an exocet. Was taped to his back. Yes, he came up with nothing but fresh air. Bit of feeling in this game, isn't there, suddenly? Oh, they put it down again. Francis Milliardos. They've got nothing but fingertips to it. Marinara has it for a Storm.
Well, it's a different looking Storm side in the second half, especially in their defensive line. They're really giving it to the Warriors, getting out, trying to force them into error. They're not holding back, they're not sliding.
Bobby Kearns, it's about to go back to Bowen. There's Perinara, looking for a gap, but doesn't eventuate. It's just inside the Warriors' 10.
Numbers out wide. This is how football should be played. Let the ball beat the man, and that's exactly what happens. Aaron Moore for his first one tonight, 42 in his career, and none more important than this one if they are to come back.
Another tough one for Matt Orphan. His first one was from wide out in the first half. so. The best of strikes once again. Deep enough distance. Not the region of the height. It's 24 points to 8. Trails by 16. They're inside that three converted try margin. Warriors with injuries. They're on the bench now. Second half, the men on the field will do the majority of the work in this final half an hour. Probably just 28 minutes to go between them in the finals. They don't know if they're right to be there. Here's Kearney coming at Stacey Jones. They've pulled him out of the fence so far tonight. Able to single him out, and here's Richard Swain.
No, he's been strong for him tonight, Stacey Jones on the right hand side. The Storm, you just get the feeling. On a bit of a roll. The Warriors are not moving up quite as fast as they were early in the game.
Kevin Campion doing a lot of work in defence, this time around the legs of Swain Hill on the last tackle. Will kick away from David Miles. It bounced off the upright. Sat down. All the Melbourne Storm, I think it was going to go dead. So it was probably a good play for them to hit the post. Here's Justin Murphy stepping across the defensive line of the Melbourne Storm. Still inside his own 20. Philly comes to Villa Sandy. Here's they were getting in the first half, unavailable to him now. Deep from dummy half. Inside his own 40. Looking for a 40-20, and he will get one as well. Great kick. Robbie Ross.
Yeah, you're right, was that
had a chance to get it.
Yeah, sorry, I think
didn't
that,
play at it, in fact. And now the Warriors will have it from inside their own 20.
Well, that was a great kick there by Stacey Jones. Robbie Ross had the opportunity to knock it back, and he just let it go over the touchline. Great kick, Stacey Jones. Points in this set of six, the game might be all over.
Yeah, just wait. Just take it easy.
Looking for a break.
Just wait. There we go.
Something to go their way in this second half.
No, get in. You get in.
No pressure on Jones for that kick whatsoever.
No one, put it in.
Just watch it. For a couple of mistakes here tonight. Oh, that's all timing. Pretty quickly from dummy half. Torpy is contact over the top once again. Farfilly. Spiral pass. Hard one to Jones. To deep. Turns it back for Campion. On with the second attempt. Miles. Basketball over the top to Goodenbill. Similar play to the way they scored a couple of tries in the first half. Here's Campion. Another offload, back to deep. The Storm will be out in their foot. This continues. Oh, no, Miles just down and got to him. Miles hurt himself here. Oh, they can't afford this, the Warriors.
Yeah, he's jackknifed himself. And four.
He might have done a knee here as he went the ground awkwardly.
Just bring it in, Francis. Just take it off him.
Certainly isn't too good.
Just bring it in, Justin.
Can he get back to his
just
foot
wait.
At the moment?
We're going
to
wait.
Look at it again. Oh, he might have twisted a knee there. That right knee under the body weight there of Russell Bowden. Going down by flies at the moment, the New Zealand players. Here's Jones. Comes and camp with the run around. Silas Sandy was there. He was ranging as he took it. Last tackle. Deep. They look for six more tackles with the grubber. Is it played out? No, it wasn't. Goodenbill.
Standing there.
Justin Murphy has a 10-meter eventually, I believe. Did rule six to go. That will be tackle number one. Took a long time to rule it. Here's Goodenbill. Away to Jones. Cardiac bottles. The Storm swung. Corbury coming back from the angle. He's 14 metres away from the line. To Villa Sanders. Kearney dispensed from him pretty quickly. Oh, certainly should have been penalised for walking off the mark there. Here's Jones. Grabbering again, looking for the end goal. That took a long time to get there. Awful cleaned up, threw a pass away, and they got back into the field of play by Matt Guy.
Well, I thought Stacey Jones was taken out of play there. It was great work by Matt Guy and Matty Orford to get the ball out.
Good tackle from Miller Sandy. Would have been justice. Melbourne Storm to get back into the field of play because Miller Sandy, the mind, walked a long way off the mark. Now Bell's got the flop himself. Here's Kearney doing likewise again. I still can't get a penalty. Kearney is blowing up. Here's Orford who has done that one. Now the whistle will blow. It's still playing on for the moment. Somebody pick it up for Melbourne. There's the penalty coming to them. There was a great chance to score. They towed it down to it. And now David Miles and Penny Nara are off to the fights. Ding, ding, ding. Thank you.
Monty Beaufort ran in there. It could be some trouble.
Straight away from Monty.
Anybody else? We've got Monty Beaton as well, I think. Okay. Rod, here, thanks. Here, thank you. You stay with Mark. Monty, here, thanks. Monty! Monty! Here! You've come in with a cheap shoulder charge, totally unnecessary. And Monty, when there's something like that happening, you stay well out of it, okay? Well out of it.
I've just been there.
Okay, both of you are away. Let's have Robbie Kearns.
I'm captain.
Oh, you're captain, right here. And Kevin, is it you or Stacey? Listen, just listen here for a tip. No, it's a penalty over here for the late shot, okay? Let's just settle this down. Listen, but don't walk away. You're going at 100 miles per hour. Let's get some structure and settle it down. That's it, no more talking.
Between Howe and Campion. They have been going at it all the second half.
And Orford will find the line. They need lots of points and need them in a hurry. Here comes Randy Howe. What happened? Leading from in front. Jones lashed out at him in the tackle as well. Now Robbie. Charging on it as well. Jones. Sniff here. They need points. Ross to Orford. Short ball for Hill. Not much doing there. Orford didn't draw anybody and they set upon Hill at a great rate. Take a long time to get him to ground. Tim Manley is right over it. He's got his hands full. Swain will play it. Orford. Come out ball. Over the top. Bounced up beautifully for Rodney Howe. Torby won't take any chances. He toes it dead.
I am watching it, okay?
It is very spirited out there at the moment. Huge contact to the tackles. The Warriors are a good job of slowing down the play the ball tonight. Here's this little slow one as they lift Hill high above the ground. Perenara. Comes the Matt Brewer. Storm lead him now. Richard Villasanti, strong work from Oakley and Campion. Great tackling. Here's that. To Orford. Another cutout ball. He finds Aaron Moore. Jones stops him. Just inside the 10. Here's Curry. Going across field. Comes to Jason Deith. Takes him with him. He'll almost get to the
line. Stand up, Dominic. No,
they've been this place a lot in the last couple of sets, but they just can't get it across. Swain to Danny Williams. He turns it back for Arua. The Warriors keep a straight defensive line. Daniel Anderson. Morrison would love this from them at the moment. Here's Hill. Last tackle once more. He, on the last tackle, was forced to make the pass and put it down.
That was a great set of six there by the New Zealand Warriors. They've got a lot of resolve around their football this year. They're really gutting it out in tough situations. In the past, we've come to know from the New Zealand Warriors that they might fold in the last 20 minutes of the game. But they know that they're playing for a spot in the eight.
Wait with me.
First time ever the New Zealand side will make the top eight in this competition. They're playing with their lives at stake.
Along with every other team playing for a top eight spot, Storm and Lockwood.
Fire pass. Oh, they've passed it inside their own 20. And given the Storm another
cool it down, Quentin. Cool it down.
Everybody's having their two bombs work at the moment. This pass didn't need to be thrown. They lead by 16 points. They're hoping to pass inside their own 20. You give them a round and they go and do that one.
Well, this is where you need Kevin Campion and Stacey Jones just to settle.
Nice and easy. Nice and easy.
Obviously, the tempo's been lifted.
Yeah, nice and easy.
The Melbourne Storm.
Let's go. Monty, get in here.
In their next set of six, they've just got to keep it simple. Make the Storm work it out from near their try line.
Stay in there.
Soon get sick of doing that.
Kevin Campion has just come from the field. The Warriors now only have two changes.
Stand up, play properly, Danny.
Williams. Back to Swain. Oh, looking for interception with Stacey Jones. He was offside.
Hold it! No.
No,
was he deliberately offside? Wait for it here. There, let it go. There's the mark.
Slow down the play. Use up more time on the clock. Cleaning tries to go from the quick tuck. And they stop him. Swain. What a way. He didn't really know about it because the pass was too flat. What a play that was. I can't believe they've done that.
Well, obviously, no communication. They just needed to work. But again, Laurie's been speaking about it. Building pressure, building pressure. They just let the valve loose then.
Tell you what, either of these teams, one of them will, in fact, make the finals. More likely the Warriors, quite obviously, but they need to just compose themselves a little bit better than they have in the last couple of moments with the ball in their hands. This would have been a start, a simple start, but Deeth taking it from dummy half, making the hard meters they need. And now Jones will get the kick away. He's still inside his own 30, but at least they got through a set, and they make the Storm work from inside their own half.
That's got to be the game plan. Game plan until you build some composure back into your game. At the moment, the Warriors are certainly trying to match the fancy razzle-dazzle that the Storm are trying to produce. They just need to get back to going forward, getting the kick chase right. Then the other stuff will follow.
Jones coming to it. He knocked the ball to ground with his hands. He might have been facing his own goal line, but there's plenty of those get caught and knocked on.
Did he play at it?
I'm with you, Laurie. Did he play at it? I don't think Guy did at all.
It's Francis Billy. Another piece of luck for the Warriors. I'm going to say they have in the field tonight. Oh, good tackle again from the man, the Panther, who just sits back on his heels and throws himself at the Matt Rua. He has unbelievable timing.
Let it go! Let it go!
Go! Go!
He's turning. Goes for the Kiwi Kearney. Jones. Pushing across the left-hand side. Melly. Back on the inside. Touched by somebody, touched by the Storm, but not played, that says Tim Mander. Matu Tony plays it quickly. Here's Jones in the last again, inside the 40 once more. With another 40-20 on the far side of the field. Matt Guy put the head down and headed back to where he thought the ball was going to come down, and then we throw that pass. And here's Aaron Moore. own side of halfway. Brought it to Perinara. Guttenbier can't wrap him up. Miller said he came with the help of a couple of others. Guttenbier came again. Stuck right down again. Here's Williams. Ruart outside him. Good shoulder tackle by Francis Melli. Picking him up. Guttenbier didn't need to do that. What's it going to help slow the play down? Hill, ball back for Williams.
Good job!
To Swain. Down to Robbie Kearns. Back to Richard Swain. They need to go left. Orford has it. He's in the hole. Tukey can't stop him.
After points, you tend to get a bit of a roll on. You run a bit harder. And just to drop the ball in that situation just relieves the pressure.
Here's Farfilli. Valentini is back out there. Spending a long time on the bench in this second half. James. Comes to Villasani. An angled run, running back towards the ruck. Left, they need two converted tries to stop the Warriors, of course, from scoring any more points. Swain, Abel Rorty, he pops it back to Richie Swain. Williams, they hem him in. Swain going with Rory outside him. Good deal from Marco, he's alert to it. An important tackle now, Hill. Orford. Rubbering again. He's got Dyer chasing through. Murphy though there. Pick it up.
Hand off
the chance, man. Off, but the kick was too big. This stage of the game, you need to perhaps keep with the hand and keep the grubbers for the last couple of tackles.
Well, we look at the Warriors side. They have had plenty of injuries. tonight, and there's some guys out there that are really struggling on the footy field as they get a penalty again.
Pick on.
And yeah, pick on. Will be sent to the pen.
I've told you 50 times.
Stephen Gale, only one of the one tackle, goes across the halfway line. just one replacement left? Or have they made them all the Warriors?
Sin bin.
6. Here's Gunn, going from the base of the scrum. High tackle by Toby Player. Here's Scott Hill.
Excitement right after this.